Well, we've got a special pot power panel today at 4:20, and here Pacific, almost at 4:20. We missed it by a little bit. All right, so a great panel for you guys. Sean Dunagan is a speaker of the Law Enforcement Against Prohibition, that's LEAP, and he's a former intelligence research specialist at the DEA, so that's really interesting. And Paul Chabot is president of the Coalition for a Drug-Free California and author of Eternal Battle Against Evil. He's a combat veteran from Iraq, and he has served as a police officer, parole board commissioner, and a White House senior advisor for law enforcement, so both with great records here. But what's interesting is that in Colorado, there's support for legalization. 49% to 40% people say legalize it, and then for medical use, it's a whopping 68 to 25. And then Harvard professor Jeffrey Myron said that if we did legalize, we would actually save $8.7 billion a year from law enforcement, et cetera, and we would actually get another $8.7 billion in tax revenue. Okay, so that's the argument for legalization. Paul, why don't you tell me what the argument against legalization is?
There's many, and again, thanks for having me, Cenk. Let me address Sean real quick. I know he belongs to Law Enforcement Against Prohibition. As a law enforcement officer, we'll say that most people that are part of LEAP are not law enforcement officers. They take anybody and everybody. So we don't want your viewers to be misguided in the fact, thinking that cops are coming out of the woodwork joining them. They're not. It's a fringe group. Let's talk about legalization for a moment. First off, drug usage today is about half of what it was a generation ago. The money that we're spending today is education, prevention, treatment, and enforcement. We got more kids, though, entering drug rehab for marijuana than for every single other drug combined. The THC, tetrahydrocannabinol, about 33% more potent than before, links to testicular cancer, schizophrenia, depression. It's a train wreck that we don't need to go down that road again.
Well, Sean, obviously, I got to let you respond to that.
Well, I certainly disagree. LEAP does have many law enforcement members. Our founder, our executive director, was a former major in the Maryland State Police. So that's just not true that it's a fringe group. I would certainly invite your viewers to come look at our website and see who we are and what we're about. We are not a fringe group. What we do realize is that the war on drugs, we've been fighting it in exactly the same way for 40 years. We've spent $1 trillion. We've arrested 40 million people. And the drug problem is not getting better. And, you know, yes, there's been a reduction overall in some drug use, but there's been an equal reduction in tobacco use. And to accomplish that, we didn't have to put anybody in jail. And we didn't have to militarize our police to do it. And we didn't fund a civil war in Mexico to accomplish that. So I just, you know, I really disagree with that. I don't think that, that Paul's taking an honest look at the drug war and the collateral damage that it's caused.
Paul, let me ask you a question. Now, look, I'm honest with you guys and with the audience as to what my perspective is. I think we should legalize. So just so you know where I'm coming from. But my question to you is, when do we win the war on drugs? I mean, do you really think that, you know, a couple of years from now, that's it, mission accomplished, we win?
Cenk, great question. Let me tell you, I'm 38 years of age. When I was 12 years old, I went through rehab for marijuana. Been at NA and AA working with addicts for 25 years. Been there, done that. We've already got legal drugs and alcohol and prescription drugs. And look at the problems we have today because of those two legal substances. Prescription drugs have overtaken marijuana use in this country. They already are. They already are illegal for unauthorized use, but they are legal. We regulate prescription drugs, and look at the increase that we have amongst our use today. And let me address the drug war. We don't call it a drug war. LEAP does, the sensational folks in the media. It's a cancer. We've got to treat this problem. My argument is this. We're never going to eliminate 100% of the drugs off our streets, much like we're never going to eliminate crime off the street of L.A. Just because you've got crime on L.A., streets of L.A., you don't say, well, let's take the cops off. They're not winning the war on crime. It's not like that. We've got to treat this as a cancer, but we can't have fringe groups like LEAP who take anybody and everybody to start marching down the streets like they're doing today on 420. It's shameful for them. And this guy's not even a cop, for crying out loud. Never carried a gun.
All right, Paul, I'm going to let Sean obviously respond to the charges against him, but I got to let you know, it's not fringe. Now a majority of the country, according to Gallup polling, says that we should legalize pot, period. So it's, you're in the minority. Just let's be clear on that. You've got a lot of great credentials, you have interesting experience, but you're not in the majority. You're in the minority of people.
Cenk, I've got stats to reverse what you just told me on those numbers.
All right, well, you have stats, I have Gallup polling. All right, go ahead, Sean.
Well, I've got my home state of California.
Uh-huh. Right. Well, that's exactly right. You know, the most recent Gallup poll found that 50% of Americans support the legalization of marijuana for recreational use. So it's certainly not a fringe position. You know, with regard to what Paul went through when going through drug treatment, I think that's great. I think the same thing about the friends and colleagues I've had that have gone into treatment for alcohol abuse, right? I mean, I'm certainly not a pro-drug spokesman. What I'm saying is that the drug war has not been effective. It's done a lot more damage than good. And to say, well, we don't call it a drug war anymore, well, that's just a change in semantics. You can call it whatever you want, but I spent 2 years from 2008 to 2010 in Northeast Mexico, and it sure as heck is a war there.
All right, Paul, listen, you know, we've tried this, keeping it illegal for a long time, and as we tried it with alcohol, it didn't work. People still take the damn thing, whether we want them to take it, whether we think it's a good idea or a bad idea, and so it seems like this, well, what it's done is, I mean, in Mexico, to you know, what Sean is saying there, 50,000 dead. I mean, it makes me sick to think about that. I mean, don't you get that making it illegal is creating these gangs just like it did with alcohol and Al Capone, et cetera?
Cenk, you're wrong. You're misled. Look, Prohibition actually worked. Drug usage decreased significantly, and the women's movement got fed up with their husbands coming home drunk, laying in the alleys. Prohibition began a generation before the government came cracking down. My dissertation work was on Mexican drug cartels. To think that if we legalize drugs, cartels are going to go away is nonsense. They do human smuggling, weapon smuggling, DVD smuggling. It's not about drugs. It's about the money. And again, I tell you, look at my home state of California. 200 cities now have banned marijuana dispensaries because they're sick and tired of the nonsense. The few cities that allow them, like San Francisco, go to San Francisco, look at the parks. Who's in the parks now? It's people shooting up, smoking dope. Parents don't take their kids to the parks anymore. I'm a dad. What kind of country do we want our children to grow up in? And that's the bottom line. And Cenk and Sean, that's the fight we should be fighting every single day to keep America great.
All right. By the way, part of the reason the dispensaries are gone is because President Obama is on path to break George Bush's record for raiding dispensaries. It's not because people are sick of them. It's the federal government doing the crackdown. But everybody's clear on this. You guys presented your opinions on it clearly. And if you're with Paul and you think prohibition on alcohol worked, well, then great. Continue the prohibition on marijuana and see how that turns out for us. I appreciate both of your opinions.